Hi, welcome to another episode of Webcam Sessions. This week we're going to talk a little bit about recording your ukulele, different microphones and other fun toys that you can use to record yourself to get a more accurate representation of what you might sound like so that you can watch it and get some feedback for your own playing. We did a video last week about the importance of, you know, feeling good and looking good while playing. And this is sort of the sequel to that, to be able to have some devices that can help you record, as well as talk about the optimal way of using them. Now, unfortunately, microphones are one of those things that you can spend as much money as you want on. And we're not going to talk about the break the bank versions. We're going to talk a little bit what I like to use. And we're also going to talk more about how to position microphones when recording a ukulele. So just the act of recording correctly, or at least in a more optimal way, can make a cheaper microphone sound much better. Now, the first thing we have to talk about is analog to digital audio conversion. And so basically what happens is anytime that you're using a microphone, it's going to need to take that analog audio and convert it to digital to be able to record into a computer, smartphone, tablet, whatever else. The easiest way for that to work well is to buy a microphone that has it built in. And these microphones will communicate via USB or plug into your phone through the in the case of iPhones and iPads and things, through the lightning jack or whatever else. An example of this is the microphone that I tend to use, called the Apogee Jam. And this is just plugged directly in to my desktop via USB. This is the mic that I like to use the most. I'm going to talk more about this in a moment. But another good one is the Yeti microphones, or the Snowball microphone made by the company Blue. You can get those relatively inexpensively. I've actually attached a few links down below of some different microphones that I like, starting about around $50. What's important with this is it plugs in via USB, or again to your phone and the bottom jack or whatever else, and it will convert the audio to digital for you. A common misconception is that you just got to get a microphone that can like plug into a headphone jack or plug into the microphone jack on your computer, and then the audio conversion is going to take place through whatever the sound card is that's actually being used on that device, and that usually is not as good as the USB microphones have. So it's better to have a USB or other, you know, peripheral than it is to have microphone just plugging directly into a headphone port or whatever else. Not to say those can't be used, but just in my experience, it tends to be better that way. And so there are two main types that you can plug directly in your computer. One is one like this. This is the Apogee Jam. This is my rest in peace Apogee Jam, because my dog got to it a couple months ago. That was a very sad day. But what an Apogee Jam does is it plugs into the computer, and then in the bottom it actually has an instrument input jack, which you can see mine is thoroughly messed up. But I can just plug an instrument cable in. So if my ukulele has a pickup, like mine does, I can plug this in the computer and go to be able to record. I love these things because they don't care about what other sound is going on in the world. I can go to a beach or a circus and record directly my ukulele with this and not get any other sounds. But that's also the problem with it, is by not having any other sounds, you don't hear any finger noise or whatever else. And sometimes that can be a good thing, both for the recording as well as getting more of an accurate representation of how much sound you might make when playing. So this is the Apogee Jam, and the thing I mentioned earlier, the Apogee mic. I really like Apogee products, in case that's not clear. I am not sponsored by them, although Apogee, if you're watching this video, I love these products. Anyways, so this is the Apogee mic. This is what we call a condenser microphone, and it's called a large condenser microphone. And the reason for this is because inside here is where the microphone is, and you see it'll actually be facing out this way. So wherever I point this microphone, it will pick up that sound. And this one has the audio conversion built in, just like what I was talking about. It plugs in via USB. And it's really easy to use, because what I can essentially do is adjust the gain, meaning how sensitive it will pick up the sound. I can see right here by this indicator light if I'm being too loud. You'll notice it will flash red if I'm too loud, otherwise it'll stay green. Right now it's blue because it's not actually on. And this makes my life really easy for recording videos for students and other things. The mic I'm using right now for these sessions is right here. This is a special type of microphone to pick up voices and things, but if you're playing ukulele, these tend to be best. And I prefer these large diaphragm condenser microphones for recording ukulele. I just find them to be the easiest to use. And so let's talk a little bit about using them, right? When we have a microphone like this, oftentimes they have a stand built in, which is preferred, and we can set them up on our table or whatever else to record. Now, people oftentimes think that you should take the microphone and then you should take the ukulele. And when you're playing the ukulele, you should put the microphone right in front of the sound hole like this. And that is so wrong. Putting a microphone right in front of a sound hole is a great way of getting a terrible sound out of it. What's funny about recording instruments is the intuitive thing is not always the best thing. What I like to do, what I find gets the best tone, is when you take your microphone, you make sure that it's pointed towards this bout down here, actually. I like to have my microphone about, let's see if I can get this all hooked up, about a foot and a half away or so, maybe a little bit closer. And I like it to be pointing directly towards this part of the instrument. And I want to make sure that the microphone isn't pointed up either, but rather pointed directly in there. So if I'm playing my instrument and I have a mic set up, you'll notice that unless the microphone is on something lower than where the instrument is, show you guys my desk here for a moment. Woohoo! All right, let's make it a little brighter too. The joys of video stuff. All right, let's do that. There we go. All right. So right now the microphone is on my desk and my ukulele is pointed kind of directly at it, but the ukulele is actually lower than the microphone is. So what I would do is I would take a chair that can move up like this or whatever I can to be able to get that to be pointed right in towards the ukulele. A lot of times this means you can use something like a stool. I've got a stool that my iPad's sitting on right here. And if I can get the chair higher, I'll have the microphone set up to be able to record like that. So again, what I'm looking for is an angle right towards this bout of the instrument, just about like that. Now notice how this is not this, right? Again, the reason this is so bad is it's too close and it's too boomy. We get way too much sound coming from the instrument when we record right over the sound hole. So that's why I like down here. Another popular method is recording more up towards the fretboard. So pointing the microphone more over here. A lot of times people go from over above and use a mic stand to facilitate that. And that's going to give you a better tone too than pointing directly at the sound hole. I can't stress enough how important it is to just not face a microphone directly into the sound hole of the ukulele, because it's so much more difficult to control the tone, and it oftentimes gets kind of that wolfy type of sound that just doesn't sound great. So pointing it again more over here can really help. There are several different types of microphones in terms of shapes. You might have heard me just mention that this is a large diaphragm condenser microphone. This would be an example of a small. You see it looks like a pencil. The microphone is right here, so could be pointed again right towards this sort of area. This is the microphone I use for when I want to do higher quality recordings. This one I have to plug into something else and then plug into my computer to convert that audio to digital. And I'll talk more about that another episode, but this one does not have that USB capabilities. So I don't use it as frequently, but it does tend to have a higher quality sound. The thing that you want to be careful of is anytime you're using what's called a dynamic microphone. And dynamic microphone's the typical voice-looking microphone, right? I actually don't even have one down here. But the, you know, when you picture a rock star on stage singing, that's the microphone they're using. The problem with those is they're meant to have a lot of volume all at once, and so that's why vocalists tend to use them, because they can put it right up to their mouth, sing very loud, and it will be able to pick it up better. And it doesn't work very well with the ukulele, because the ukulele is a little bit softer, and that's where the condenser microphones tend to be better. So if you've been trying to mic with one of those type of microphones, you might notice it's harder to get a good sound out of. Now again, this is all just my opinion, and this is becoming quite a long rambling video. I don't know a lot about audio and audio technology. I kind of just know what I've needed to know to be able to do this and to find what sounds best for me. So if you're somebody who likes to use a certain setup and you get a great sound from it, that's great. And there's nothing that I can say to, you know, make that different. But this is more for people that haven't really worked on it before and are trying to, you know, dabble in recording themselves. So the moral of this story is try to record more from this area, be a little bit further away from the microphone, foot to foot and a half or even more. Don't record right over the sound hole. And I find that large condenser microphones tend to work best. So if you guys have any questions, please leave a comment below. This is a little bit different of an episode because I did a lot of talking about information that should take longer than 10 minutes to talk about. But check out the links in the description below for all of the different microphones I suggested here. And we'll talk a little bit more about this in the coming weeks. But I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next week for another episode of Webcam Sessions.